Arenvold! I can't tell you how good it is to see you.
It arrived a lot sooner than expected, eh? The day I craned my neck up at you.
Only because you're sitting down. Unless...
Afraid so. The Kyrurgeons say I may never walk again. Come on, Alfino, it could be worse. Besides, I didn't come here to dampen the mood. Quite the opposite. All I've ever wanted was to fight for a cause I believe in. But my fighting days are over. So I want you to fight in my stead. Be the hero I can't.
I am no hero.
That's what they all say, though. No one ever calls themselves a hero. Even the ones who eat primals for breakfast. It's for others to decide. Look, Alfino. You already are a hero. To me and countless others. We see you doing your damnedest to protect us all. And you're not alone, are you? There are people who believe in you, just as you believe in them. I know what's at stake, and how many people are depending on you. But I believe in you. Believe that you'll see it through. That's why I'm entrusting my dreams to you. Like Albert and Owly once entrusted their dreams to me.
There was a time when I would have borne the weight of such expectations without a second thought. But now, I know just how heavy that burden can be. To tell the truth, I'm beginning to wonder if I chose the right path. Sacrifices will inevitably be made for the sake of the ideals I uphold. Maybe I am not the person I thought I was. The person you think I am.
I wouldn't presume to tell you. But I will say this. In spite of everything, you've come this far. The road ahead might not always be clear, but you've never been one to give up or take the easy way out. And everything you do for others. For a brighter future. I'm proud to call you my friend. Well, I've said my piece, so I'll let you go. I know you've got more important things to be doing.
I shall, my friend. And we will meet again soon, I promise.
Nothing left for me to do but wave and smile.
You've got a pretty narrow view of what it means to be a hero, do you know that? You think they're all forged in the fires of battle? That it's all about being brave and killing villains? Alphino and the others will carry on their fight. But theirs isn't the only one. There are other ways you can make a difference. If you stop feeling sorry for yourself and put your bloody mind to it.
There's not much chance of me living the quiet life with you around, is there?
If you're content to twiddle your thumbs thinking of what might have been, that's your lookout. Then I reckon you've got some fight left in you.
And I reckon you might be right. If there's a way I can still help my friends, I'll bloody well find it.
My fellow Scions, as I am sure you will have heard, we can expect no help from Charlian, nor are we any closer to discerning the Teleferoi's grand design. And now, our adversary moves against us in unprecedented numbers, compelling us to answer in kind. The outlook, in short, is bleak. Yet though our foes are many, and we but few, we may still tip the balance in Eorzea's favor.
Of course. We will do what we always do. Deal with the ones our allies can't. A less than daunting prospect, judging by your expression. Could it be that you've dispelled your lingering doubts, Alphino?
Oh, I doubt I ever will. But as my friends have kindly reminded me, I have come this far, and that must count for something.
God be good, Alphino. That's what we've been trying to tell you all along.
For one so bright, you can be remarkably dim at times. There is such a thing as overthinking, you know.
Might I suggest that we continue this conversation after the battle? It would appear that Teleferoi have already arrived.
I'll do what I can to cure the Tempered, but they'll have to be incapacitated first.
Have care, my friends, for none can say wherefore our foe did choose this fateful field to be our battleground. Whatever may transpire, pray grant him not the pleasure of deterring you.
prepare yourself!
Let's give it our all!
Hold fast.
And thus another plan went up in smoke. I am beginning to see why Lord Zenos thinks so highly of you. Not that this changes anything, you understand. You have merely earned yourself a stay of execution.
Alimor.
How fair the tempered?
We've treated as many as we can, but some were beyond help.
Do not hang your head so, brave scions. Though not all of our captured brethren could be saved, we are grateful for those whose minds have been restored. You could do no more, and that is enough. So please, hold your heads high.
Should have been quicker, but I'll do better next time. Thank you for your kind words. They mean a lot.
A victory at great cost, but a victory nonetheless. We must stay strong and press on. Isn't that right? That
Agreed.
We will!
Thank you.
Those Eorzeans certainly are a stubborn bunch. Though I suppose you knew that already. My plan to redirect the ether from Cartano came to a rather less than satisfactory conclusion. It was, in many respects, an abject failure. Which does, of course, raise the question of where we are going to procure the requisite amount. The obvious solution would be to draw on resources a little closer to home, though that would require our dreamer to dream a trifle more deeply.
So be it. The dreamer will not complain.
Then let us begin the preparations at once. With the gateway of the gods complete, all that remains is to gather the necessary ether, and our prize shall be within reach. The time has come to fulfill your heart's desire, my desire! To relieve those wretched creatures of their meaningless existence!
While I await you, I shall drink a sea of souls and gorge myself upon the darkened moon. Then you shall come to me, all roiling rage and rancor. And the stars shall bear witness to our final contest.
As I thought, the ethereal currents have been disturbed here too.
It was the same in Thanalan. Make that every location we surveyed.
And the strength of each current has diminished dramatically, far more than could be attributed to a natural occurrence.
What tidings bringest thou from Dravania?
We took a number of readings, and noticed that the closer we were to the tower, the lower the etheric density became. In short...
The towers are drawing upon the land's ether, which would explain how they were able to carry out the summonings.
Our allies must be informed of this. We should return to the Rising Stones and have Tataru relay our findings to them.
Hear me.
Hear me.
Hear me.
Hear me. Darkness comes. And with it, the end. The fate of the star is in your hands.
Everything all right back there?
Thank you.